I quite like it. All right, thanks for stopping by, everyone. This is Brawl Dev, and in this episode, this is going to be a little different, because we're going to be talking about a new instance Roblox has added, I think sometime last week as of recording this video, called Unreliable Remote Events. Now, it sounds like a pretty weird name, but it honestly does have its practical use cases. It's just a matter of understanding what the heck is the difference between unreliable remote events versus remote events. So that's pretty much what I'm going to try and teach you in this video from a general perspective, because I'm not a networking expert, so I won't be able to go too much into detail with what goes in the back end, but I want you to get a grasp of unreliable remote events and how you can use them during certain cases over remote events. So with that being said, let me show you what I'm talking about. All right, let's think about this for a minute. Before we can understand unreliable remote events, we first need to understand what remote events actually do. So I made a video about remote events. The link to that will be in the description if you want to look at it. But what actually happens when we communicate from the server to the client or client to the server with remote events? Well, basically with remote events, let's say we had Fire server being called, and then we had another Fire server being called, and then a third one after this, and then finally a fourth one after this one. So this is pretty much going to be fired in sequential order from when we first called it, and then it's going to keep going down here until it reaches the bottom. And this is not only sequential, but it's guaranteed that this will go through for each one of these communication calls. So it's a very secure method. It'll give you a guaranteed response when you do call the other side of the game with remote events. However, there's a downside to this. When you send information through the network, so when you're going from client to the server, it basically is saying that we need to pass through the network using information in these little packets. So when we process it and make them go through, then it's going to take a little bit of time because remote events are secure and reliable. But it takes up more network bandwidth when we do try and send information over to the network. So when we realize that this is the only way of communicating from either sides of the game, what if we wanted to do very small things? This is basically where unreliable remote events come in, from what I can tell, where it's essentially a counterpart to remote events that you can use for those very small instances that you want that communication, but don't want it to affect the network as much when you do it. So when I mentioned that for remote events, it's reliable, secure, but slow, unreliable remote events are basically fast, not secure, and not reliable. So what this would look like is, let's say I had Fire server right here, the first call, and then for whatever reason, I wanted to fire the server again and then fire the server again. These would basically happen unordered, and it's very unpredictable which one of these would actually go through. This one would probably go through, but this one might not even go through because it's processing it very quickly through the network without affecting it. And there's no guarantee that it's actually going to go back and process our original request for it. But the upside to this is that it's fast and it doesn't take up a lot of network bandwidth. So that's the benefit of using unreliable remote events. And this isn't like an extreme do this or do that instance. It's more like you need to know what is more useful depending on what you're trying to accomplish. So let me show you an example that explains this in greater detail. So for this example, I'm going to show you a fire extinguisher that I modified to use unreliable remote events. And I basically took this example from a blog post that I read from Boyned back in 2021. And he pretty much explains how unreliable packets are sent to the network and how it pretty much correlates to what I'm going to be showing you here. So if you have the time, I highly recommend reading that blog post. I'm going to put a link to that in the description, and I highly encourage you to read it once you finish watching this video. So I pretty much have this fire extinguisher. If I hold my left mouse button, then it's going to spray a bunch of foam, and it's going to follow the direction of the player mouse whenever this is activated. And then when I let go, it stops doing that. And what also happens is that when I press the button, then it's updating the mesh for my tool to show that it's being fired or it's being stationary. So let me show you what this looks like inside of the script. So if I go to starter player and open up my fire extinguisher, there's a remote event and an unreliable remote event being used. Let's look at our local script here with the bubble script. So we have two things happening here. When we press down our mouse button, It's calling this toggle gear remote event that's being fired to the server, and it's doing the same thing for when we let go of the mouse. That's pretty much how we can play the sound and also change this mesh. Let's go to the server and see what's happening. Oh, and by the way, an interesting point is that the syntax is exactly the same for unreliable remote events and regular remote events. So we can have fire server, fire client, on server event. So the syntax is exactly the same, and you don't have to worry about learning anything new for that. And then when we're firing toggle gear onto on server event, that's how we're able to update this thing. So you might ask, why are we using a remote event for this instance? We're using a remote event because we need that guaranteed response that this fire event call went through, because we need this mesh to update. This is what's important, and we need to have it in the exact order. So it will take up more bandwidth in the network, but this is something we need to happen. And this is basically only being called one time. That's why it's okay to use a remote event. But now you might ask, how are we creating all this foam, all these bubbles, onto the server? This is being done using an unreliable remote event, as shown in this local script right here. So while the tool is spraying, we're constantly calling this unreliable remote event, and we're passing in the direction of the player mouse. And this is being called every 0.05 seconds. So you remember from the beginning, we're only calling this one time whenever we click on the mouse. But here, we're calling it every 0.05 seconds, so this will take up a lot of bandwidth in the network. When we're doing it here on the server, this is being called every 0.05 seconds. So it's very fast. We're gonna need to call this a lot of times. And what's important to note about this is that when we create bubbles, it doesn't matter whether some of the fire server events actually run through, and we don't care about the reliability of whether this does go through or not. We care about this mesh being updated. That's why we're using remote events, but we don't care if one little bubble doesn't go through with the fire server call, because every single bubble that you see here is calling fire server. So we don't even notice whether this is actually going through or not. And since we're calling it so often, we want to use a better method of sending packets through the network using this strategy. So this tool too, this is the fire extinguisher that uses unreliable remote events. This second fire extinguisher uses a normal remote event. So let's see what happens if we do this. So visually it's not that much different, but through the network, it's taking up more bandwidth. And essentially, unreliable remote events are just one of those optimization strategies that you should use if you know when to use it properly. But throughout all this time, we haven't used unreliable remote events until recently, and this is a very new thing that developers are now stepping into to try and see if they can apply this to their Roblox games. And I encourage you to experiment with this and try this out on your Roblox games as well. To summarize, remote events are reliable, secure, but it's slow. Unreliable events are fast, but they are unreliable and unsecure. And once again, it's a matter of experimenting to see whether they'll be useful in your Roblox games or not. And it requires experimentation. If you're still confused on the client and server model, then I encourage you to watch my remote events video that I'll have a link to right here. And with that being said, that's pretty much going to be it for this video. If you enjoyed it, then be sure to join my Discord server. The link is in the description. And I will see you in the next video. Take care.